Okay, it is 12:07 p.m. Sunday, August 16th, 2015. I don't know if you can read that or not. Okay, I'm gonna leave my phone here. Oh, yeah. Oh. Okay. I put some of those Titan sunflowers right there to come up a couple weeks ago, and they're coming up pretty good. I don't know if they'll last through the winter or what the situation is with that. I just wanted to point out about those degradable planters. I thought that would be a great idea. I figured, I bought a bunch. I bought probably about 50, 60 of them at least. Ow! And once in a while, I need pops when I walk, so you have to understand if I start yelling. But see, now, this is a Marigold tomato. It was planted, oh, I don't have the date on this one. But I put the name on it. But see, this is what they look like. This is my composting out here I put out here. See? It's been at least 3 months, two or three months that I planted in here. Because I stopped using these. I used them for a while, then I stopped using them. And I'm debating whether I'm going to use them for peppers next year to get them started. So I'm saving a bunch of them. Whether I use them or not, I can throw them out. Here is eggplants. It was planted June 5th. I can't really make it out. 6'5 on there. Okay. That potting soil, I don't know if it's got, I don't think this is potting soil either, because usually potting soil is what seemed to grow, help grow everything start out in the house. I got some in there right now that are growing that are small. I mean, this is the 16th of August. We got until middle of October generally. Well, I don't know. Man, God keeps changing the weather. And I'm getting really pissed off with that here. But you know what? It's okay. It's okay, folks. Just go outside and breathe in the air. Breathe deep. Take long, deep breath. Yeah, you'll be dead soon. This one was from April, an eggplant. I just left it in here. See, nothing. I watered them, and then my wife had put some stuff in like this container here, not this one, but one inside the house. Put water in the bottom, and stuff was growing a little bit better. But still, nothing of any significance. I'd say if I save these for next year, I don't know how much or what I'll put in them. This is a Marigold tomato. I don't have a date on here again either. But, you know, like I said, look at that. Yeah. And again, people go, oh, you need to use it. And well, you know what? I haven't had to use that for anything that was out here. If you've seen the earlier videos, that look at the okra. This will put out until it dies in end of October, November. We come out here last night, I picked 51 pods of okra. We're freezing this stuff whole. We're slicing it and freezing it. We're dehydrating some of it too now. Finally, we got a dehydrator. So, you know, okra is a really high vitamin concentrate. Again, like I said on previous videos, I've never even looked it up, but I just know it's really healthy for you. I got a couple of peanut plants down there. I gotta wait till they completely die off. And so that would be like mid-October, end of October. But the okra is still coming. These are dying off. I'm collecting the heads of the torch sunflowers. You can see a lot of the black heads on there. You gotta pinch those seeds out. It's very time consuming. I got about a fourth of a 5 gallon bucket. And then I have some heads from some of the sunflowers, not the deformed ones, but the other sunflowers. So that's basically gonna give me, you know, days of winter things to do. But we're gonna research about the okra if they can leave those up, because some of those things are about the size of a tree trunk. The bottoms of them. So, we don't know, are we gonna have to cut those all the way off? If we do, we're gonna cut them down, fold this in half, till that, and then till it up if we have to take them up. But otherwise, we're gonna take out about a third of those out of there so they'll have more space. But, Lucy, listen. So this is why I get aggravated with these. I thought they were a great idea that you can just plant them in the ground, which I've done with some of those peppers over there. You break the size a little bit so they break up easier in the ground. Leaves, I try to keep the leaves out because of the diseases that these trees seem to keep with them all the time. The label. Uh, But, you know, I say these would maybe starter cups for next year. We'll have to see if there'll be a next year, even for that matter now. One more. Okay, this one here has got a Amish tomato, June 5th. Amish paste tomato. Okay, see, same thing. Everything was planted exactly the same way. Some come up, some not. So if there's any constructive comments about what maybe I could do, that, you know, don't tell me something stupid as far as watering and things of that nature. I know how to do all that. But we've done everything the same. And some of the stuff came out. Some of the peppers came out. Over there. And we got a couple of pepper plants on the far side. I replanted a tomato over here. I can't send it to the viewfinder. Right there, that little green one in that basket. And there's one behind it that's dying off. We had two over there, but the wind out here has been so heavy and so bad. It's knocked stuff over. I mean, actually knocked them over. Cage and everything. This one has nothing on it. So, again, I'm taking out the potting soil, whatever in here, with my grass clippings and hiding stuff. Your usual compost stuff. We were taking the ends of the okra that we don't cut off, you know, from the stem, and sometimes the tip part, and throwing it into a compost. But the Sioux tomato, Super Sioux, Coluto, Casaluto, whatever. And like I said, this is what it looks like. Yeah, so I chopped down some of my sunflowers over there. You can see I got a little thing full of their stalks for fire. And this all is all, it's gonna be a big process. But it's gotta be done. I'm gonna move all these flowers. They're gonna be back, as I said in the previous video too. You can see those notches there. They're about 6 feet back from the plastic. That's where the flowers will be. I'm gonna make those two closer together. Maybe even come this way a little bit more. And from CJ's grave, I might try to make it even over here, like maybe even further back, like where the shovel is here, and come over close to about where this is. Keep a break here so I can get to the compost. And have these flowers back here, the sunflower, the Titan, which are the big yellow ones, and the Torch, which are the orange ones. Butterflies and bees all over them. And even the hummingbirds were over here too. When we were out of sugar a couple times, they would be over here trying to get some nectar, which they did. They stayed for a while. We got flowers like that up in front too. Hummingbirds love them. But other than hornworms on my tomatoes, the tomatoes had put out quite a bit. I just killed about 7 hornworms today. Man. But I've got purple pole bean right there growing out. I planted one in the back. It's coming up. I got Jackson Wonder bean back there. Purple hole pea back there in the back, because now they've got all that space. I'm hoping they'll grow, you know, with the lack of bees, or the low, you know, the lesser of bees and butterflies to pollinate. The black-eyed peas in the far back. The purple hull peas over there, disease or whatever, all over the pods is like little eggs and shit. I gotta get rid of all that. I tore up the zucchini squash because they had those squash bugs all over them. I wanted to burn that, but I sprayed the hell out with that soap water insecticide, and I put a little dishwashing liquid in there. Killed 99% of them. There's a couple of them that were crawling around. Wanted to burn that. Don't want to burn it on the plastic. Don't want to burn it on the grass right there either. So I might end up putting that in one of those totes and take it over to my burn barrel area and burn it there. But we're still taking this down and still harvesting stuff. There's a cantaloupe over there I want to get today. Had that planter on it last night with a brick, so no animal got to it. There's two more on there I saw last night too, little green ones, like on the other side. And there's a couple of cantaloupes I had planted coming up too, just little leaves. But I'm not going all the way over there, so you can see what it looks like now. If you don't grow yourself some food, I can't have any sympathy for you. I really have a hard time having empathy for anybody. I mean, understandably, if you're in a city and you can't grow anything, even a 5-gallon bucket in your house, in a window or something. Other than that, you know what? whatever happens to you, look in the mirror. That's the person that did it to you.